Hello dear students, how are you? After a long time I have come to your midst. Today I shall take the class on English second paper, and our today's topic is write for of verbs. That means in Bengali we can say verb er shothik roop. We know many English grammar rules, but here verb is a important verb is an important thing. So let us go discuss on right form of verbs. If you don't know tense, I mean you don't know anything, because tense is a very important. So at first I shall discuss a sentence. He go to school regularly. Okay, what is the verb will here? You know, here is a word regularly, and also some words regularly, often, daily. If it is remains in the sentence, then it will be the present indefinite tense. So he goes to school regularly. Here adds es. If the subject is third person singular number, then es will add after main verb. After main verb es will add. That means he goes to school regularly. Here the another sentence look at. What will be the verb in this sentence? You know or not know, if the sentence is universal truth sentence, then the sentence will be present indefinite tense, and If the subject is third person singular number, then here is also add s with rise, that is rises in the east and sets in the west. Okay, not only universal truth sentence, if it is habitual fact, look at the sentence, father read the newspaper every day morning. Here the sentence is a habitual fact, that means abhyasgata karma. So the sentence will be also present indefinite tense. So the subject is third person singular number, then the sentence then s add after reads. Okay, here look at number one sentence. Here subject is he, then verb is goes. If the subject is others, if the subject is I or we or they, then the verb must be first person, the verb will be main verb, and here will not add s or es after verb. So the verb also will go to school regularly. I go, we go, they go. They go to school regularly. Only the subject, if the subject third person singular number, it may he, she, it. Here they are pronoun. Then we can say the other sentence number 4. Here the other sentence, look at here is also verb go, but what is the form of verb? Here is a rule. In this sentence, now is a word and also other word at this time. Now, if the words now or at this moment in the midst of sentence, then the sentence will be present continuous tense. So we can write I am going to school now. Let us the another rule. Number 5. He do the work recently. Here recently is a word, and if the words recently, yet, already, never, ever is in the midst sentence remains in the sentence, then the sentence will be present perfect tense. You know the structure of present perfect tense. Here at first you have to write subject, then has, after has, verb will be third person singular number, past participle form. He has done the work recently. Do will be done. That means do is present tense and done is present past participle form. Here, see the another rule. If, for, or since in the midst of the sentence and noted time in the sentence, then the sentence will be present perfect continuous tense, and the sentence will be he has been, and the sentence, then the sentence will be present perfect continuous tense. So the structure of the sentence is he has been reading the book for 2 hours. Here the structure: after subject, has been added, has been add, has, sorry, has been add after subject and after verb add ing. This is the present perfect continuous tense. So here some word will remain in the sentence, and you will understand what will be the tense. Now we shall go the next rule. Here is also a sentence. If the word yesterday, ago, long ago, then the sentence will be past indefinite tense. So the structure will be, instead of main verb, went is the past form of go. So I went to school yesterday. Okay. So this is the our today's topic on right form of verb. If you try to understand the rules on tense, then you will be succeeded. Dear students, today I shall I have to end the class. So thank you all.